Hi, I'm Daniel from ratings.com. NVIDIA recently released an update to their graphics card drivers to allow their 10 and 20 series graphics cards to support variable refresh rates with FreeSync displays. In this video, we will briefly describe what these technologies are and what this change means for you. We'll go over the tests that we are now conducting on FreeSync displays, and we'll also go over the results from the 25 FreeSync monitors we've tested so far. You can also see our article, which is linked below, to find more results as we continue to test FreeSync displays. First, for those who don't know, variable refresh rate refers to the ability to dynamically match the refresh rate of the display to that of the content. This is especially useful for gamers, where the game's frame rate may vary during demanding scenes. This is important because with a fixed refresh rate display and no synchronization, it causes screen tearing to occur when the refresh rate of the content is out of sync with the refresh rate of the display, and you don't use V-Sync, which has its own downsides. You can learn more about this in the article which is linked below. There are two main technologies that are marketed with this synchronization feature: FreeSync, which was developed by AMD, and G-Sync, which was developed by NVIDIA. In the past, use of variable refresh rates has required matching your display and graphics card with the same technology, as they were not compatible with each other. This pairing of technologies comes at a price, as NVIDIA G-Sync displays typically retail for a couple hundred dollars more than their FreeSync counterparts. On January 15, 2019, NVIDIA released an update to their graphics card drivers to allow FreeSync support with newer 10 and 20 series video cards. This allows you to make use of variable refresh rates on cheaper and more widely available FreeSync monitors. As a result of reader feedback, we decided to add a test for FreeSync compatibility with NVIDIA graphics cards and have tested the 25 FreeSync monitors we've reviewed so far. Note that there is a G-Sync compatible certification provided by NVIDIA, of which only 12 monitors have passed. We don't know exactly what they test for, but if you have some insight or know of any other tests you would like us to perform, then please do let us know. Most of the FreeSync displays we've tested perform the same whether used from our AMD RX 580 graphics card or our GTX 1060. This includes the same variable refresh rate range. There were a few notable exceptions though. The current implementation on NVIDIA graphics cards requires a DisplayPort connection, so some FreeSync monitors which only have HDMI, like the Acer XF251Q, aren't supported. This also applies for the current Samsung TVs with FreeSync support over HDMI, like the Q6FN, which isn't supported. The Samsung UJ590 monitor experienced constant tearing and artifacts when used with our GTX 1060, which we haven't experienced with our AMD graphics card. The UE590 also experienced strange artifacts. All of the monitors we've tested that allow you to adjust the overdrive settings for response time also expose these settings when using FreeSync from a NVIDIA graphics card. This can be useful to tweak the motion blur and avoid overshoot or smearing artifacts. Note that this is different to variable overdrive, where the overdrive adjusts dynamically throughout the FreeSync range for the best motion. This isn't currently something we test for, but let us know if you think that we should. Some monitors require you to choose a basic or extended FreeSync range for the best performance. For example, the 27 UK650 experienced issues with the extended setting, but we didn't have any problems using basic. So overall, it does appear that most FreeSync monitors appear about the same whether you're using them from an AMD or a NVIDIA graphics card. There are a few exceptions though, so check out our test results to see how your monitor compares. We test all of these monitors with our GTX 1060 graphics card. To enable FreeSync, open the NVIDIA control panel and under Manage 3D Settings, look for the Monitor Technology option. Set it to G-Sync compatible. Then go to the Setup G-Sync option under Display and enable G-Sync G-Sync compatible. To test the performance of these modes, we use the freely available pendulum test pattern, which is linked below. We adjust the frame rate of the test and look for screen tearing, and use this to test the full variable refresh rate range. We also take note of any excessive smearing or if there is any flickering. So that's it. You can check out the testing article on our website for an up-to-date list of compatibility, as well as additional information about how we test. Let us know if there's anything else we should test for in the comments down below. Also, let us know if you've got a NVIDIA graphics card and have tried this feature yourself. If you like this video, subscribe to our channel or become a contributor. Thank you for watching and see you next time.